this collection. So we have all of the winning ideas have prepared their own pictures, and I will introduce each of them to you. So I want to start off with the first idea, the first winning idea. The first winning idea comes from Greece. And I hope it works, because internet is a bit slow. The reason why I put this song on, if you recognize it, Strangers in the Night. Well, actually, Valia and Leah were strangers in the night, in the plastic night, before they joined forces and met each other at the PlasticTwist workshop in Greece. And now, jointly, they are representing the Blue Ballot Project, just to show what teachers can do.
Hello, I'm Valia.
I'm Leah.
And we're very happy here to be here with you today to present our idea and also listen to the other people's ideas, and hopefully we will also get many things from them. Oh, thank you. So I work for the Axios Delta National Park. So I work for the communication. So I've been organizing cleanups for the last 12 years, 2, 3, 4. Coastal cleanups. So I had a lot of exposure to the problem of the marine plastic pollution.
I am an architect and a circular economy product designer. So you understand that this joint of forces maybe will be very successful.
So I was, this problem of plastic pollution has been torturing my mind for the last years. So the PlasticTwist workshop was a good chance, opportunity for me to discuss it with other people and try to work on a solution. So, let's go out. Just to give you an idea about where we are, this is Thessaloniki Bay. The city is over there, the second largest. Salonik is the second largest city in Greece, in the north. We are 600 kilometers away. So, this is a quite closed gulf, and it is. There are areas here like the Axios River, the Aliatmos River, the Aliki Kitrus. There is a salt producing unit here. It's a protected area and Natura 2000 area. So, just to give you a couple of pictures of the area, this is the Kalahari Lagoon. You see the beauty, it's very near the sea, and we are very happy, we're very lucky to have wildlife near the city. Just a couple more pictures. This is Olympus Mountain.
It's not touristy. Just showing you that it's a real place.
And this is aerial view of the Axios Delta. So, this is the mussel cultivation. It's a very important economic activity for the area. 80% of the mussels are being produced in the area of the Western Thermaikos Gulf, and also 80% of the mussels are being exported. So we have 147 families earning their living from this activity, and also many workers and a larger chain of economy around them. What is the problem? The waste produced by this activity, and during the cleanups, I had the opportunity to realize that could be 80 or 90% of the problem on these beaches of the Western Thermaikos is really from the activity. It's blue barrens and also fish, the nets they use to for the cultivation. And also the ropes. So yeah, that was the image I wanted to show you. Actually, this beach is in Aliki Kitrus, and because of the currents of the Gulf, the whole, the biggest amounts of the pollution is being washed up on this beach. Not that the other beaches are clean, of course, but this has got the worst of the problem. So you can see those are the blue barrels. You see hundreds of them. They, when there is a storm, a bad weather, they become detached from the cultivation and they stay there until somebody goes to pick them up. Even those nets, they are even worse because they go under the sand. It's impossible to drag them. And this is a protected area and you cannot put a machine on it. So the riddle is immense. And of course you also get bottles, like could be even from the north, the south of Aegean being transported here. So these are the nets I was talking about. You just can cut them with a knife. And this is a recent photo of a flamingo that was entangled in these nets. And it was 2 weeks ago, a volunteer sent it to us to show us the problem. And they sent the volunteer team to try to save the flamingo. So, last year there was this Up for Litter program, and there was they tried to register, can I have some? To count the amount of trash. And unfortunately, this beach was by far the most polluted beach among the 22 beaches that that were counted in this Up for Litter program. 12,000, almost 13,000 plastic items found in 100 square meters. And the second was just in 2000. So, we have also local people who are expressing their desperation for the problem, and they cannot feel proud of their pretty land because it's like that. So, in the national park, we are trying to solve the problem by doing these cleanups. You see, that was the image before, that was during the cleanup, and magic image. But the solution is not cleanups, you all know, because it will become, in a small time, it will be like that again. So, what's the challenge? First for me is to implicate the locals, and mostly the master farmers, because unless we ensure their cooperation, the problem will always be there. One thought is just to find them, but you know, in Greece the public services are not really, they don't have the funding they should have, they're not there the time they should, and plus I have taken part in meetings with marine police, with municipalities, with environmental agencies. They tell us I have to be there when they do it, when they throw the nets in the sea. If I'm not there, I cannot find them. So all we can do is make them our allies. So of course, create value from the plastic trash. This is the whole point of the plastic program. But the mussel farmers. Okay, I need to go on. Bye.
So here comes the blue barrel project. It was after listening to Leah and being convinced about the local issue there, we tried to take what was the negative part of the negative aspect, the blue barrels, the symbolized pollution, and turn them into a positive result. So we suggested we create a social cooperative with members of the local community. The farmers themselves, if they wish, us and everyone who would want to participate and work to that direction, members from the local community, municipality, and etc., involve them and create synergies between different sectors of the local community. Implicate the mussel farmers, make them, motivate them actually, to not see the pollution as something segregated from their work
and their everyday life. And understand that it's their kids that go to that beach. They're the kids' schools that teach or do not teach environmental education in their area. It's their families that are being affected by the issue. So, yeah, organize cleanups, of course. Not just to clean up, but to enforce this involvement of the locals. And organize educational programs to work for a future clean culture. That's allow me this... Yeah, okay. So this, what I told you right now, the solution, is, let's say, visualizing this circle, which at the first step, like go collect, we actually involve most of the people who would like to be part of it, and especially the farmers themselves, the mushroom farmers. The second is the cleaning and getting raw, that's how we call it, but we mean the whole process of processing and industrial process of the plastic in order to get the raw material. The third is how what we actually use in this. I think Peter mentioned earlier that it's not just to get the raw material again, but to create these branches of different things that you should be in order to be really circular in your community. And of course, reuse yourself. This is a diagram that is even more explaining what I told you now, so that you can see that we actually did implement the people in them. So we get, okay, we do the plastic cleaning with the social cooperative. Then we get to the recycling part, and then we have three branches. Like we do a secondary printed plastic items from filament created from the raw material. We also transport raw material to an artist that is collaborating with us and doing trash and shows, upcycling fashion, in order to create awareness. And the rest we give to the plastic industry to recreate, fix through the plastic barrels again, and sell them in a better price, to the mussel farmers themselves. So you see the circles, the bigger circles. And this is our thought of how we could, in the future, use the plastic toolset, the plastic twist toolset, and promote, exchange, and demonstrate what we do as a social cooperative in the local area of the Michael's Belt. This is a show, an image for the fashion show that I told you. It's actually all made from, I don't know the word, but it's aluminum and plastic. Sorry. I hope you understand that you got the feeling and that you get the most important part, which is that we really want to solve a local problem and from that create a global approach. Thank you.
Very high standards for the next winning awards, but now we have a new idea. Unfortunately, Louise could not be here with us today. She might be having her baby right now at this moment. So she's here with a video.
Thank you. I'm originally from the UK, but I immigrated to Switzerland in 2012. I've also got a growing interest in sustainable fashion. I launched my own accessories brand in 2015 after I decided to basically leave corporate world. I used to work in buying merchandising for some pretty big names in the UK. And my company, Xander Fashion Limited, is certified vegan by PETA. I'm part of an offer alliance. I'm an active member of the Living Wage Foundation, and I like nature and psychedelic music. So, previous work, I used to be, for a better word, a plastic polluter. I used to create custom jewellery made from new plastic. This was in 2016. 2017, my collection started to change, and I used to, my plastic use got smaller. 2018, then I had replaced all of my plastic with wood and wooden alternatives, and I stopped using acrylic and polyester in my collections. 2019 was the first collection that I launched using all wood and metal components. From here then, my idea was to take it one step further, so I wanted to basically fall in love with plastic. What I started to do was I started to collect HDPE plastic bottles, and I arranged them into colour palettes that I thought essentially were pleasing to the eye. From here then, I prepared the plastic, so I delabeled all, I delabeled the bottles, and I basically prepared them ready to be shredded and melted. I cut them, obviously, before. And then from here, then, as Julie mentioned before, I collaborated with Fab Lab. So it was in Fab Lab that I started to shred these plastics. And then the manager at Brand Lab, Chris, created a hot press machine where we took the shredded plastics to create these plastic plates. And then from this stage then here, I collaborated with the People's Factory, where I used their milling machine, and we started to mill then these sheet plastics into geometric shapes, or in my case, earrings. And then from here then, we devised a way to not use a glue, so we cut circles in the back of the earrings, and then heating up the ear posts, I melted the ear posts into the jewelry so that they were now glue-free. And then we've got some styling shots and ideas about how to wear my collection. Going forward then into the future, another step that we had then was I designed the custom-made packaging. So my product comes in the leopard print boxes, and we've got self-supporting stands, essentially, to keep your jewelry safe. Towards the future, then, this was my initial idea to make ear wraps. From here then I went back to Fab Lab where I used the injection machine. So going back with the shredded plastic, I injected them to make ear wraps. One stage further then, to take it back into my brand, my logo is the skull, I designed a custom 925 silver bar to attach the earrings, obviously, to wear them. And we've got some processes here of me finishing. These are the ear wraps. Since I actually did the presentation, the bar's now being finalized, so I got pictures of that for Instagram. And yeah, that's my presentation basically. So.
I'm happy I'm not voting because I wouldn't know how to vote. So the next presentation is by Tim Doy. When he was a kid, he always dreamed of being a pirate. Well, actually, nowadays he's not a pirate. He is a king. A king with a nickname. He's King Neptunus. Not Neptunus. And why? Well, just have a look at his presentation and you will understand why he has this nickname now.
Hello, thank you. So, my name is Tim Rooij, I'm from Plastic Playgrounds. The ocean, a beautiful, pristine environment and one of the most important ecosystems for us humans. Without the ocean and its resources, we would not be able to exist. And I had the incredible opportunity to explore this vast landscape and sail across the Atlantic Ocean. For me as a pirate, a dream coming true. But we are also on a mission to do research to the plastic pollution. This is the boat we used to sail from Bermuda to the Atlantic, to the North Atlantic, to the Azores, to the North Atlantic plastic soup. Islands loomed out of the mist, where we had to stop for provision. We had amazing sea life around our boat, day and night, like this dolphin. I saw the most spectacular sceneries, sunsets, moonsets, and clear starry skies, like we were floating in space. I swam in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean, in the deepest, bluest water I ever seen. And this is how it looked like most of the time, clean and blue. But we also saw lots of plastic. I came across many of these sites, ghost nets. They're also referred to as ALDFG, abandoned, lost, and discarded fishing gear. When they enter the ocean, they keep doing what they're meant to do. They are trapping animals. And because of this, they are four times more deadlier than any other type of debris in the ocean, any other type of plastic debris. And I learned around 640,000 tons of fishing nets enter the ocean every year. And they're responsible for killing hundreds of thousands of marine animals. For example, the turtle, but also whales, dolphins, sharks, fish, seals, and seabirds. So it's an ecological disaster happening at this moment and a problem that needs urgent attention. And I found out that in Turkey they recognize this problem. And the last 4 years they implemented the program in which they removed almost 400,000 square meters of fishing nets from the coastline. So well done to Turkey. So I want you to let this sink down for a moment, because I want to talk to you about another passion of mine, and I think of so many others, sports. Sports, they bring people together, and they are really important for our well-being, for our physical, but also mental health. But still, sports and sport events are far from sustainable at the moment, and a lot of wastings are generated every year, while they could be circular. So now we have these two different subjects, fishing net waste and sports. And we were thinking, wouldn't it be amazing if they could benefit each other on the road to become circular? So we were looking at these two subjects and think, where do they actually meet, these two environments? And we found out this is at the beach, where we go to play sports. But we also see a lot of fishing activities and abandoned fishing nets. So we had the beach, we had sports, and now we also had this pile of fishing nets from which we had to make a new product. And suddenly we came with an amazing idea. And from this idea we created a product and a business concept. Would you like to know what we came up with?
Yeah.
Alright. So I'm honored to present to you the first circular sport in the world, in which we only use recycled waste streams to make the equipment to play it. And it's called Beach Atom. Thank you. So the Beach Atom paddles we make by recycling fishing nets. And the Beach Atom nets, which should have been there, but aren't, we made from repurposed fishing nets. So by playing Beach Atom, you're not playing only a fun new sport, but you're also contributing indirectly to cleaning up the ocean from fishing net, and you're stimulating circularity in sport. Next summer, Olympic year, we're going to produce 10,000 of these Beach Atom paddles, which we sell to people that love the ocean and want to invest in the ocean by playing a new sport, but also people that want to just play a fun new hip sport. So it's not only the people that care for the ocean, but also others that can contribute to cleaning up this beautiful area. But this is not all, because we're also going to offer a Beach Atom experience. We already saw lots of cleanups are organized every year, but what is done with the waste? Well, we found an answer to that. We started a project, the Dare to Beach Different cleanup tour. Well, you see, you know the problem of the fishing nets, but we will go together with a school, a company, or beach lovers, and do a coastal cleanup. And with the plastic waste we find, we will directly, hands-on, recycle them into Beach Atom paddles, which, of course, then we will use to play a fun game of Beach Atom. And we are using the newest technology for making mobile recycling machines, so people can recycle the plastic directly on the beach and see how circular economy works. And we can not only make Beach Atom paddles of this, but also any other type of product. So with this project, we create awareness, we provide education about circular economy, but also give people help by playing a sport. And we are aiming bigger, but we're aiming even bigger than this, because I'm so happy to tell you we got invited as Plastic Playgrounds to go to Tokyo, the Olympics, to show our project there. And this is the start of a 4-year project we got to implement, which is called the Road to Paris. In these 4 years, we're going to use Beach Atom to showcase circularity in sports and startup discussions. But also we will consult the Olympics, but also other sport events, how to make sports more circular and waste-free. So in 4 years, Paris will be one of the most circular sport events ever. But we didn't forget our main goal, which is to clean the oceans. So 5% of all our revenues will go to clean the oceans with fishing nets. And we're already in business. We have a product, the Beach Atom paddle, and we already sold it. 20 examples. We provided experience. At the University of Wageningen, we are playing Beach Atom at the moment. And you're looking at the first Beach Atom trainer in the world. So we're also creating employment. And we are consulting for Tokyo, the Olympics. And like this, we're contributing to 4 different sustainable development goals, which we also find very important. So I ask you to join this Beach Atom revolution and help us to save the ocean and the marine life from fishing net pollution and make sports circular. I dare you to be different. And to close off my presentation, I want to share with you one particular moment in this amazing ride I already had. To make my first prototype, beachcomb paddle, I had to wash 25 kilos of fishing nets. And while I was doing this on my roof garden for 8 hours, a certain image came to mind. It was the car of Elon Musk flying to the moon. And I thought, how is it possible that we have the technology to accomplish this? And I am standing here, washing fishing net with my bare hands. But it also made me realize there is still so much more possible. And we're just starting to recycle plastic from and plastic fishing nets. But to make this happen, we just really have to want to do it. And for that, we will need your help. So please invest your tokens in us. Plastic Playground to make this work. Let's do it.
Okay, so we're going over to the last idea, the last presentation of the day. This presentation will be done in Turkish, but there will be nice images for those who don't speak Turkish. And I think I need to start learning Turkish quite quickly, seeing all the good ideas that come, and I'm sure that the next one will also be. So I'm quickly introducing to you Sinan. Sinan is the trash man. He's an obsessive reuser and revaluer of plastics. In fact, his shop, everything is in the shop, is reused, revalued, and recycled. So I give the floor to an actual and real trashman. Sinan, pleasure.
Thank you very much. Hoş geldiniz. Evet, iflahımız bir geri dönüşümcüyüm herhalde. Özellikle de çöple beraber. Ne görüyorsunuz? Bu bir çöp mü? Hiçbir zaman bunu çöp olarak görmedim. Asla çöp değil. Her zaman geri dönüşebileceğine inanmıştım ve en ufak şeylerle dahi plastiğin geri dönüştürülebildiğini herkese ispatladım. Ama en güzel olan şey, bunların hepsinin parasını siz ödüyorsunuz aslında. Bunlar hepsi ödenmiş sermayeler. Alışverişlerinizi yapıyorsunuz, evinizi götürüyorsunuz ve hepsinin parası ödenmiş. Bunlar aslında birer değer. Bu değeri tamamını, yani gıda sektöründe %40'ını kapladığını düşündüğünüzde çok büyük bir alan kaplıyor. Ve bu çok olamaz. Asla çok olamaz. Ve bunun %55'i dışarıdan ithal ediyor. Yani demek ki biz bu çöpü ürettiğimizi düşünürken aynı zamanda cebimizdeki para da çok uzaklara gidiyor. Ama bunlar bizim kaynaklarımız. Biz bu kaynakların %17'si olan tamamen raflarımızda duran gıda ambalajlarını hepsini geri dönüştürebiliriz. Çünkü bunlar özel plastikler. Hepsi gıdaya temasla çok yüksek kalitede üretilmektedir. Bunların geri dönüşümlerinin yapıldığı, daha doğrusu kullanıldığı yerler, ilaç şişeleri, süt şişeleri, yoğurt kapları, bütün diğer kullandığımız, tükettiğimiz ürünlerin içinde durduğu ambalajlar. Bunların hepsi çeşitli plastik kalitelerinde ve ürünleriyle yapılıyor. Ve bunların hemen hemen hepsi geri dönüşüme müsait ve geri dönüyor. Yani bununla her şeyi yapabiliriz. İlk yapıldıkları bütün ürünlerde bir tekrardan geri dönüşebilirler. Onlara tekrardan şans verebiliriz. Bu Valia. Bu fikir bize ait, bana ait ama buradan çıktı. Biz burada zaten bunu yapıyorduk. Yani tüm geri dönüşüm poşetleri veya tek kullanımlı poşetleri geri çağırdık. Kağıtları, viyolleri, her şeyi. Ve bunları biz müşterilerimize dönüştürüp hediye olarak vermeye başladık. Viyollerde fideler, tekrardan kullanılabilen poşetler, hele hele paralı olduğu zaman Türkiye'de bu çok rağbet görmeye başladı. Çünkü kimse para vermeden almak istediğinden onların kullanılabildiğini de gördüler. Kendileri de poşetlerini ceplerine koyup getirmeye başladılar. Bari bunu nasıl yapacak bunu? Çok basit. Önce kontrol etmeye başlayarak zaten yaptığı şeyi. Sonra yavaşlatarak. Yani bu plastik tüketimini yavaşlatarak. Ve yeniden kullanmayı insanlara öğreterek ve göstererek. Sonra yeniden dönüşümü sağlayacak sistemleri kurarak. Çok küçük bir işletme olmasına rağmen etkilediği çok insan var. Çünkü yaklaşık 11 yıldır sektörde tek başına küçük bir işletmenin yapabileceği her şeyi model olarak diğer insanları ve diğer işletmeleri de sunuyor. Yani açık kaynaklarla çalışıyoruz. Hiçbir şeyi saklamıyoruz. Yapılabilecek her şeyi bir yanımızdakinde öğretiyoruz. Bunun için en önemli nokta tüketiciler. Benim de içinde dahil olduğum sizlerin hepiniz. Çünkü sizi tetiklediğimiz zaman tüm sistemi tamamını tetikliyoruz. Bir sektörün değişmesini beklemek için makine parklarından, ticari alanlardan tüm ekonomik koşulları etkilemek lazım. Ve bunun için çok büyük güç ve sermaye gerekiyor. Ama hepimiz biraz küçük sermayeyiz ve gücüz. Biz bir araya geldiğimizde her şey değişiyor. Öyle bir değişiyor ki biz bile bu rüyaya inanamıyoruz. Bizim buradaki rolümüz Valia Organic Store ortada olmakla beraber tüm plastiğin geri dönüşebileceği 3 alan var. Bunun yarı mamul veya mamul olarak kullanılacağı yerler, plastik ham madde yani granül olarak geri dönüşüm yapılacağı yerler ve depozitolu geri çağıran üreticilerin almayı planladıkları üretim ambalajları yapacakları yerler. Bunun için alttaki doğa dostu hediyelerimiz var ama onun dışında tüm plastik kullanılmış geri dönüşüm ürünlerin müşteriye token kazanarak verilmesi müşteri için bir cazibeye dönüşecektir ve özellikle herhangi bir geri dönüşüm kaygısı olmayanın kazanç olarak bile bu sistemi destekleyeceğini düşünmekteyiz. Bu modellerden ilk birincisi ve bence günümüz teknolojisine de en uygun olanı mevcut 3D printerlar için filament yani kartuş üretecek olan sistemler. Ve inanılmaz bir şekilde Türkiye'de bu makine yani dünyada iki yerde yapılıyor ve bir tanesi Türkiye'de ve şu anda çalışır vaziyette. Yaklaşık 6 ay sonra da raflara bu ürün çıkacak. Yani aslında çok basit, çöpten sermaye veya ürün üreten bir dükkanımız oldu. Şu makineyi alıp koyduğunuzda kendiniz kartuş yapıp satabileceksiniz. İnanılmaz bir geri dönüşüm hikayesi. Ve bunlar bizim çöp diye düşündüğümüz ürünler. Tüketicinin bize getirdiği tüm çöpler bir şekilde bu geri dönüşüm yerine, merkezine veya herhangi bir gönüllü açmış olduğu yere gittiğinde sırayla bütün herkes geri dönüşüm olarak token kazanıyor ve bu token'ı hızlı kazanmamızın sebebi gerçek dünyada paraya çevrilir bir ürüne dönüşmesi nedeniyle. Ve bu ürün şu anda gençler arasında ve teknolojinin kullanıldığı tüm alanlarda, modellerinde inanılmaz şekilde tüketiliyor. Filamentlerin ne kadar çok satıldığını ve ne kadar çok para ettiğini veya para harcandığını görseniz inanamazsınız. Ve çok hızlı bir şekilde Türkiye'de devreye alınabilecek bir sistem ve Ankara'da bunu yapan bir firma var. Dediğim gibi hafta içerisinde de bu ürünü raflarda göreceksiniz. İkincisi, ham madde dönüşümü yapan sistemler. Bunların en büyük sıkıntısı, plastikleri geri dönüştürürken çöplerden toplandığı için temiz ve ayrıştırılabilir bir plastik olarak değil de çöpten ayrıştırma plastik olarak ve plastiğin kalitesini bozuyor. Bunun dışında geri dönüşüm merkezleri plastiği dönüştürürken sertleştirmek için çok fazla sülfür kullanıyor ve kullandıkları sülfür plastiğin ekstra kalitesini bozuyor. Yani burada tüketicinin geri dönüşümünü sağlayacak olan bir sistem ve token kazandıracak bir sistem temiz plastiğin geri dönüşüm ve merkezlerinin daha hızlı çıkmasını sağlayacak. Bu da temiz bir ham madde elde etmenizi sağlayacak. Elde edilmiş temiz ham maddenin maliyeti daha ucuz olacak çünkü bu iş sorumluluk dışındaki insanlarda sadece gelir kazanmak için yapıldığında daha kirli ve en nihayetinde ayrıştırılması daha maliyetli oluyor. Böylelikle daha temiz bir plastik ham maddesi elde etmiş olacağız. Üçüncüsü depozitoyla üretim yapacak bir sistem. Artık plastik o kadar kaliteli bir malzeme haline geldi ki neredeyse camla yarışacak haldedir. Fakat kullanım alanları ve kullanım şekli olarak plastiğin çöp ve kötü olarak bakılması bir plastiğin depozito olarak en az 60 kereye kadar temizlenip kullanılmasını sağlamaktadır. Eğer bazı meyve suyu veya içecek markalarında bunun geri dönüşümünü sağlayacak sistemler kurabilirsek ve bunun üreticisinden itibaren geriye dönük bir token sistemine ikna edip kurabilirsek inanılmaz adetlerde bir geri dönüşüm sağlamış olacağız ve çöp üretilmemesini sağlayacağız. Bunun için en önemli olan şey tüm bunları son tüketicinin yapabilmesi değil, son tüketiciden aldığımız güçle Valia Organik'in yapması. Ve bu Valia Organik gibi herkes için kopyalanabilir bir sistem. Yani bize ait değil. İskiler tüm küçük işletmeler ve diğerleri bir şekilde bunu yapmaya gönüllü olanlara yapacak olan herkesle tek tek bağlantısını kurabilir. Yarım mamul üretilenlerle, ham madde dönüşümcülerle deposkodan bulaş üreticileri de. Bunların hepsi var, var mı insanlar? Bunu yapmaya hazırlar. Sadece talep olmadığı için kimse buna girişmiyor. Yani duran bir talebi canlandıracağız biz. Ve bunların tamamı geri dönüştürülebilir. Hiçbir şey çöp değildir. Kullandığınız her şey, her ürün direkt geri dönüşebiliyor. Ve bu geri dönüşüm ve token sistemi bütün müşterilere bir mutlatıs gibi çekebilir. Veya herkes. Token sisteminin Türkiye'deki en inandığım şeyi, Türkiye'de küçük küçük biriktirmeye inanan çok insan var ve küçük rakamlarla oynamayı insanlar çok seviyorlar, kum tahvilleri gibi. Ve böyle olunca takip edilir ve oyuna dönüşmüş bir sistem, token sistemi, Türkiye'de çok hızlı bir şekilde aplikasyon olarak da yaygın olarak mobil kullanılan cihazlar üzerinden hızlı bir şekilde yayılacağına inanıyoruz. Ve ortasında Valia organik ve anlaşmaların olduğu tüm modelleme birebir hiçbir zahmet yapmadan kopyalanabilir ve hiçbir değişikliğe gerek yok. Yani herhangi bir gıda satıcısı hiçbir şeyi değiştirmeden bunu yapacaktır. Özellikle ilk modellemeyi göstermek istiyorum gençler. Bu işi ister gerçekten modelleme yapmak için uzun, ister kendilerine hediye üretmek veya hayallerinin ekleyeni gerçekleştirmek için çok kullanıyorlar. 3D printerların şu cihazda dönüştürdüğü filamentler çöp olarak gördüğümüz her şeyi ortadan kaldıracaktır. Bunun için teşekkür edeceğim insanlar. Çok teşekkür ediyorum. Aynı zamanda Leyla. Bizi keşfedip buraya getirdiği çabalarımızı ortaya çıkardığı için ve bize bu günlerimizi sağlayan aldığımız takip eşini çok teşekkür ediyorum.
Turkish. I want to know all that he says. I think we'll get you to do the old charges later, but I'm really looking for it. So I want to thank all the 5 winning ideas. Can I get the contestants to stand up here on stage with me? Just to remind you the ideas. So we go back from the last one to the first one. So give them a round of applause. Thank you. Just as a reminder, we have Sinan, we have Tim with the beach atoll, we have Xander with the jewelry, we have Valia and Leeuwen with the Blue Barrel Project, and we have Louise in labor with the video of her pamphlets. So, these are the winning ideas and you're going to vote. Now, how are you going to vote? That's David who's going to explain that. He's the tech guy. I'm not. Thank you.
All right. So, the voting process. As you may have seen from the desk, there is this one page explaining you in details how to proceed to download the app and use the app. Don't get confused, you have a username and password that you should use that is indicated on this white paper, so please use it. The applications, I think we have a slide with the QR codes. They can be found on the Google Play Store and so either you browse for them the corresponding stores or with the QR codes if ever the QR codes are displayed. So I encourage you to vote. You are given a number of tokens. You are free to send your tokens to the ideas you are interested in. You can vote for a couple of them. So please vote. Thank you.
Okay, we have a coffee break now, so you can either vote here or in coffee break. The coffee break, the 3G is available, 4G, so and whatever you want, you can vote. The best place, find your best place to vote. And if you have any problems on voting, please see people with plastic t-shirts. Başak is there, and Aslıhan and Rafa. And other everybody, Pierre, Marius, Vasily, Help! Help people! And vote! Okay, we have 15 minutes, yeah? 15 minutes after we are here! Back.
For the winning ideas? So, good job, everybody! So I'd like to invite on stage before we announce the winner, because as this is like the Oscars, we like to give it a little bit more attention. So I would like to ask Davis, Ludovic and Peter, our advisory committee, to come on stage. Thank you very much. And then I would like also to invite Cezanne and Ada from the reader. They will give the prize to the winning award. So I would also like to invite on stage, and I hope I pronounced the name right, Evro Guven. I hope I pronounced the name right, but my Turkish is very... So, this is the envelope. So what's going to be in it? The winner of the 2019, we're sure it's not going to be the last time, Plastic Twist contest is Sinan with the collaborative reading of the French Plastic. Sinan, come on stage.
Kazandığını zaten gelirken de biliyordum. Çünkü bu çok büyük bir kazanç. Plastikten veya işte geri dönüşümden yapılabilecek her şey çok büyük kazanç. O yüzden tüm arkadaşlarımı da tebrik ediyorum. Müthiş çok sonra, herkesin biraz daha farkında ve çok daha fazla şeyler yapacağını inanıyorum. Bu daha başlangıç.
Thank you, Sinan, and I also would like to invite the runners-up to the stage. Sinan, your award. Sinan will give it, and please, all ideas are winning ideas because you went through a national selection. So please, come on stage and give a applause to all the winning ideas and everybody. They've done a great job. Get back two mics now. You want me to talk double? So, really, I would like to thank the winning ideas, the advisory committee, Cezanne, Ebu, for everything they've done for us today. It's well, blockchain women, sorry. It's the emotion of the award session. Also, I would like to give a very well applause, and I would like to invite to stage the whole organization team. Just stand in front here. Leila, Emra, everybody that's here. Say a round of applause for everybody from the organization. She is our winning idea from our project. Thank you, everybody, and a big applause for yourself for your dedication of being here on a Sunday afternoon with us. We invite you now to visit the BNL and join us in the conference. If you're fed up with me speaking, just leave me aside. If you want to talk to me a bit more, I'm happy to take a cocktail with anybody of you because I'm going to relax and bring some really nice cocktails this afternoon. So, and for a picture, just we have to get all together. So we have to stand in behind us.
Thank you.
We are going to the cocktail, to the ambiance bar, and the cocktail starts at 5. So until 5, we have 1 hour for the BNL visit in the building. And if not, you can go earlier to the cocktail. Okay, thank you.